Maybe let's turn our focus to Eskom now. We know that the country is in stage three of load shedding, and Eskom spokesperson Khulu Phasiwe is on the line. Khulu, thank you so much for making the time to join us. Let's unpack this phrase that's been thrown around. What exactly is stage three of load shedding, in particular with reference to the actual number of businesses and households that are being cut off today?
Well, good evening and to our viewers and listeners as well. Well, essentially, stage three of load shedding, what it means is that it's a deeper stage of or deeper level of implementation of load shedding. For example, in a municipality where you are supposed to be load shed for 2 hours, the likelihood is that they're going to add an extra hour so that they implement load shedding for 3 hours in total. But for places like Johannesburg, Pretoria, and Ekurhuleni, in Johannesburg, for example, between Eskom and City Power, we implement load shedding for 4 hours at a go. So it's unlikely that you'll go beyond 4 hours. So, but in small municipalities and other big municipalities like Devon and Cape Town, which also have 2 hour rotational load shedding, they are likely to add 1 hour in addition to what you already have.
Khulu, the anecdotal evidence suggests some people are saying we get switched off more than other people do. Is it being fairly distributed, the load shedding, among businesses and personal consumers?
Yes, I can assure you that in terms of the agreement between Eskom and municipalities, we are sticking to that principle that this power interruption have to be at an equitable basis. So town or the city or a village or whatever is being targeted for any of these things. So we're trying to balance this thing among all the people who are connected to the national grid.
Khulu, understanding that there's no particular targeting, but at a point in South Africa where we have a crisis unfolding in Durban in particular, would you get an instruction to say keep the lights on, because should the lights go off, we might actually see the situation in that part of the country accelerating?
Well, I'm afraid the instruction would not have to come from us, because obviously that will be in the jurisdiction of a municipality. So all we ask for from them to do is basically just to do what they can to make sure that they reduce the load in their specific localities. As to how they do that, then generally what we know is that they do it according to their pre-planned schedule. So if, for example, if someone who lives in Chatsworth was supposed to be load shed today, or someone who lives in Umlaag was not meant to be load shed today, you cannot move around and load shed someone in any particular area when, in terms of their plan, they are supposed to be load shed today, and therefore they have already sort of planned their life around being load shed today. So you don't want to move too much in terms of introducing changes, because it also inconveniences as much as load shedding itself is an inconvenience.
Khulu, I know this is an emotional issue, but people are also saying, this is what you hear, is that things seem to be worse than we thought and worse than Eskom is telling us. Is that true?
Well, things are not necessarily falling apart. That I can assure you, because we as a company, we have been relatively accurate in terms of preempting how the power system is going to sort of perform. And we have been trying to keep the nation in general up to date about what's going on. So some of these things we had planned and we have seen them coming before, and our engineers and technicians have been trying in the interim to make sure that our system is as reliable as possible. But it's important to remind our listeners that some of our generating units, like Khulu Phasiwe, for example, the power station there, that unit or that power station was built in 1961. Anyone who knows anything about machines, if you have something that's as old as that thing, you are likely to have interruptions from time to time, because obviously technology has moved on. Some of these machines are very sort of slow. For example, if you take out one unit of Khulu Phasiwe today and you want to synchronize it back into operation, it will take 8 hours before that machine can give you a total output of 600 megawatts. Some of the machines are old. They have a lot of technical faults, and I also acknowledge that we as a company, there was a time when we had made a big mistake of delaying maintenance, and that is beginning to catch up on us. But the aging of our infrastructure is also a big contributor to what we are seeing today.
Khulu, thank you so much for making the time to join us. That's Khulu Phasiwe. He is the spokesperson for